morning and welcome to the faith community of St. Maria Goretti and Our Lady of the Angels Parishes. Today we celebrate the Solemnity of All Saints. Our presider is Brother Jonathan. Please stand for our gathering procession.
One of us as we pray. Our salvation comes through the shedding of your blood, Jesus. Lord, have mercy. You call us to holiness of life. Christ, have mercy. In your love, you give us the witness of all the saints. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel come up from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels who were given power to damage the land and the sea. Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God. I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal, 144,000 marked from every tribe of the Israelites. After this, I had seen a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes, holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne and from the Lamb." All the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. Prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen, blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes, and where do they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Does not know us is that it did not know him. beloved, we are God's children now, and we shall be as God has been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure as he is pure. The word.
Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. So today we remember all the saints. That great multitude in heaven that we heard of in the book of Revelation. That multitude that no one can count. We constantly remember the saints on different memorials and feast days. But these are the saints that we don't always remember. The saints that aren't formally canonized. And we remember the canonized ones too. But these are all the saints in heaven that we remember today. People in a sense who made it. Who got there. People just like us. People that we even knew, some that we even knew. People from every conceivable background. The poor, the rich, teachers, preachers, moms, dads, brothers, sisters, doctors, nurses. Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI, speaking at a World Youth Day, once said that there was as many paths to heaven, as many ways to heaven as there are people. And that's what we want. We want to be holy. We want to join our sisters and brothers that we honor today, in heaven, in our heavenly homeland. We like them. We all want to be saints. But if there's as many ways to sainthood as there are people, there's got to be a commonality, right? There's got to be something that all the saints did, had they held in common. Well, there are three traits that most, if not all, the saints, you know, share. And these traits are very interconnected. From a certain point of view, they're almost indistinguishable, but it helps, I think, to talk about them separately. First, the saints have what could be called a biblical worldview. We all have a worldview, but saints specifically have a biblical worldview. You know, saints don't happen by accident. They very much see heaven as the place they want to be. You know, heaven is their goal all throughout their life. They believe in heaven, and they believe in hell. And they know heaven is where they want to end up. This life to them is just their way there, their path to heaven. As it is for all of us, this life is a path to heaven. The saints, it's not to say the saints weren't very interested in the here and now. The saints would certainly vote on Tuesday. Many of them were on the absolute forefront of the social concerns and challenges of their time. They saved for retirement. They took care of their families. But all along the way, their real goal was always heaven. That was what they were always ultimately preparing for, planning for. You know, ultimately, they didn't live for this world. They lived for heaven. And nothing expresses the biblical worldview better quite like the Beatitudes. You know, the Beatitudes that we heard in the Gospel. You know, if you believe or at least live as if this is all there is, you know, that there is no such thing as heaven and hell, then the Beatitudes make no sense at all. I mean, if this is all there is, then being poor in spirit, being mournful, hungering and thirsting for righteousness, being merciful, being clean of heart, being a peacemaker, and suffering and enduring trials for your faith and hope in Jesus make little sense. You know, that doesn't get you ahead in this world. But if you know, if you understand that this life is just a momentary, just an instant compared to the whole eternity after this, then the Beatitudes make all the sense in the world. The Beatitudes are very much a description of someone who follows, you know, the commandments we learned about last week. You know, to love God with all our heart, soul, and mind, and our neighbors as ourselves. You know, the Beatitudes is someone who puts God and others before themselves. Which is important, because even though it's not popular nowadays to say, you know, heaven's not a foregone conclusion. There is another possibility. You know, and even though Jesus begins the Sermon on the Mount, as we heard today with the Beatitudes, he ends it with that warning. He says, enter through the narrow gate. The gate is wide, and the road broad that leads to destruction. And those who enter through it are many. How narrow the gate and constricted the road that leads to life, and those who find it are few. Not the biblical, but really the postmodern worldview, if it believes in the afterlife at all, says the exact opposite. It says the road is wide, and you know, and many go through it that lead to life. And the road is narrow, and few go through it that lead to destruction. That may be what the world says, but that is not what Jesus says. That is not what the Bible says. And the saints, although they get to heaven in many different ways, they all share this focus on heaven, this focus on putting God first, you know, others before themselves. They live, or they at least try to live the best they can, the Beatitudes. They have a biblical worldview. Related to the biblical worldview, the saints also have a both and, not an either or mindset. Let me explain that. The first reading from Revelation, you know, towards the end, we hear about the vision of the saints, you know, the great multitude of every nation, race, people, and tongue. ask John, who is having this vision, where did all these people come from? Where did all these people wearing these white robes come from? In other words, where did all these saints come from? John says, I don't know. Why don't you tell me? And the elder responds that these are the ones who washed their robes in the blood of the Lamb. The blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ. The Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. Jesus who shed his blood for us. Shed his blood on the cross for my salvation and yours. The saints are the ones that get that they understand that it's Jesus that brings salvation. It's not them. It's not me. It's not my effort. It's Jesus. It's all Jesus. Jesus is the source of all grace. Jesus is the one who forgives. Jesus is the one who brings us salvation. The saints are fully aware that it's through no action of their own, no personal sanctity or through any great work that they become saints, that they arrive in heaven. It's 100% through the blood of Christ that any saint is a saint, that anyone is saint, that anyone makes it to heaven. But although the blood, the sacrifice, the grace is 110% Jesus, it still says the saints washed their robes and the blood of the Lamb. They had to do something. So it's not either an either or, 100% Jesus or 100% me. It's both 100% Jesus and something to do with me. There's some acceptance of the blood of Christ, some participation, some taking up one's own cross and becoming a saint. There is a realization that we both absolutely need Jesus. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And at the same time, we have to do our part. We have to follow that way, recognize that truth, live that life. It is Jesus. But Jesus wants my yes. Jesus isn't going to save anyone against their will. We must open ourselves to him and try our best to do his will. Saints have a biblical worldview. They have a both-end mentality. And finally, and also very much related, the saints are the ones that get back up. The saints get back up. All future saints fall down. All past saints fall down. Or current saints fall down. They may let this, they let this world its lures and temptations seduce them. They get knocked out. And sometimes they're down for a very long time. But eventually, the saints repent, and they let God help them back up. Every saint in heaven is really someone who's just like us at one point. Some of the canonized saints, just seem extraordinary. Padre Pio, the Cure d'Ar, some other Teresa. They all seem like that, like from their conception, that they were holy. But even those saints had temptations. Even those saints had struggles. Some of them incredible struggles that we could not even imagine. They, like us, were sinners. Every human being ever born, unless they're immaculately conceived or born fully human and fully God, every human being ever born sinned. Falls down, messes up, gets knocked down, and sometimes gets knocked down really, really hard. But the saints are the ones that don't stay down. They seek God, they repent, they ask for forgiveness, and God gets them back up. Yes, it helps that they have a biblical worldview, a both-end mentality, but it's through the grace of God and the mercy of Jesus Christ they continue to seek God, that they receive that forgiveness, and they get back at it. One of my favorite popular Christian songs of all time says this, the 1998 Bob Carlyle song from his album Butterfly Kisses. It's a song, We Fall Down. And the refrain's really simple. It goes, we fall down, we get back up. We fall down, we get Ms. Johnson asked her class, you know, how does somebody become a saint? You know, what do you have to do to become a saint? And little Sally, you know, raised her hand. Obviously, she hadn't heard this homily, but little Sally raised her hand and said that to become a saint, you have to be dead. You have to die. Well, little Sally's not wrong. All the saints that we recognize are dead. And the saints ultimately lived their lives in a way that was a dying to themselves. You know, through their biblical worldview, through their both-in mentality, through their getting back up every time they fell down, the saints learned to die to themselves a little bit every day. But every moment here and now, we're dying. Dying just a little bit. Every moment is a little bit closer to death. We can either die for ourselves or we can die for God and others. The saints are the ones who actually truly lived in this life by dying not for themselves but to themselves. Now the saints are not dead. They are more alive than ever in heaven. The saints aren't dead. I mean, compared to the saints, our lives here like walking in a daze, half asleep. You know, heaven is like a new birth. You know how a baby or a toddler, if that baby and toddler knows that they're loved, knows that they're safe, most of their life is just a wonder. It's full of awe, full of life. You know, every moment is new and wonderful and magical. Well, that's heaven. I mean, that's what it's like for the saints. Every moment is new, wonderful, magical, and it's eternal. We honor those saints today, all the saints, you know, especially the unknown ones. We ask them for their intercession, their assistance, and their help. As we learn to die to ourselves a little more each day, so that one day we can join them in that life, that wonderful, magical, eternal life. One God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate in the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. So as we bring our prayers to our Heavenly Father, we ask for the intercession of all the saints. And in a special way, we ask for the intercession of our country's most recently recognized blessed Michael McGivney, who was blessed or beatified just yesterday in Connecticut. Michael McGivney was a priest in the 19th century, a holy man, helped with immigrants, especially Irish immigrants, and he was the founder of the Knights of Columbus. So let's offer our prayers to our Father.
Please respond. Saints of God, come to our aid. For Pope Francis and all the bishops, that they may continue to lead the Church in a new spirit of evangelization and holiness, we pray.
Saints of God,
come to our aid. For a growing spirit of holiness in the hearts of all the members of the Church, so that we may become the saints that God has called us to be, we pray.
Saints of God, come to our aid.
For the elections that will take place this Tuesday, that our democratic process may bring about God's will for our country and peace may prevail in our land, we pray.
Saints of God, come to our aid.
For all those saints who have been a part of our lives, that they may have the reward of their goodness and may continue to be the powerful intercessors for us, we pray.
Saints of God, come to our aid.
For all the sick, body, mind, and spirit, especially for all those affected by the coronavirus, that they may find the strength that they most need at this time, we pray.
Saints of God, come to our aid.
For all the family, friends, and fellow parishioners who have gone before us, especially for Beatrice Brzezinski, Michael Ballester, Grace DePasquale, Jim Sager, who passed away this week, and for Frank Cush, whose special intentions we remember at this liturgy, that they may experience the fullness of eternal life with our God and all the saints, we pray.
Saints of God, come to our aid. Lord God, yours are the earth and its fullness, the world and all those who dwell in it. As we celebrate all the saints, may your spirit renew the face of this earth, and may we graciously cooperate with your will. Receive the humble petitions of your people, and grant that what we ask may be fulfilled. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our Mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Towards her we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the Church, through whom you give us in our frailty both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with the multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of
Savior, for my heart, grasp and renew.
spiritual resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. For our brothers and sisters who are following our celebration online, a prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your saints, we implore your grace so that coming to perfect holiness in the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of our heavenly homeland through Christ our Lord. Please be seated a moment for the announcements. If you or anyone you know is interested in learning more about the Catholic faith, you are invited to call the parish office to register for a faith study, the faith study. Our music minister, Chrissy, has released a CD called Our Journey, which features 14 original songs composed by her and sung at our parishes. If you would like to purchase the CD, it is available in the back of the church or at the parish office. The cost is $10. The songs in the CD are also now available on Apple Music, Spotify, Amazon Music, and other digital platforms. Chrissy is donating all the profits to the music ministry for both of our parishes. We are holding a lottery fundraiser at both of our parishes. A $5 lottery ticket gives you a chance to win $2,500 in prize money during the 31 days of January. The winner each day is determined by the first drawing of the Pennsylvania Pick 3 lottery. Those tickets are now available at the back of church or at the parish office. We need the help of all our parishioners to sell all 1,000 tickets. If you take some to sell, please fill out a paper listing your name and the numbers on the tickets that you take so that we know where all the tickets are. And they make great Christmas gifts. Tomorrow is All Souls Day, and there will be a Mass at each of our parishes, 5 p.m. at St. Maria Goretti, Immaculate Conception, and here at 6:30. These Masses are our special Masses that remember those who were buried from our parishes this past year. All are welcome to come and join in the prayer with the families who have lost loved ones recently. Also, at both of our parishes, there's a Book of Life in front of the church. So ours is right here in front of the ambo. And you are invited to list any loved ones you would like to have remembered during the month of November, and we will be praying for them. Volunteers are needed to sanitize the church immediately after Mass today, so if you're able, please stay and help. Whether you're able or not, please, as you leave, put down your kneeler so that they know which pews to sanitize. And do we have any birthdays or anniversaries being celebrated this year? Is it a birthday? Is it both of y'all's birthday or just one? Both of y'all? Well, happy birthday! You're 21? 22. Any other birthdays or anniversaries to be celebrated? Birthday? Anniversary? Well, happy anniversary. Okay. Yesterday? On the 5th? Okay. When's your birthday? Wednesday? Oh, big day. special masses. So please stand and bow your head for God. May God, the glory and joy of the saints, who has caused you to be strengthened by means of their outstanding prayers, bless you with unending blessings, and let the church say,
Amen.
Freed through their intercession from present ills, and formed by the example of their holy way of life, may you be ever devoted to serving God and your neighbor, and let the church say, so that together with all, you may possess the joy of the homeland where Holy Church rejoices that her children are admitted in perpetual peace to the company of the citizens of heaven. And let the church say,
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.